Welcome back to Physics Through Computational Thinking. Today we'll talk about periodic motion and dynamics. We'll review oscillatory motion and periodic motion, some of which you are already familiar with. So this is going to be a quick review about the same, and we will slowly build up on to enharmonic oscillators. Let's get started. Let's go ahead and look at an example of an enharmonic oscillator. Again, building up from a simple case into a more complex case, we look back at the simple pendulum again. Last time we showed you that the equation for the simple pendulum was theta double dot equal to minus g by L sine theta. Now clearly this is not equation of a simple harmonic oscillator, but we did an expansion for small theta and we showed that this was that for the small theta approximation, this was a good approximation to a good approximation reduced to equation of a simple harmonic oscillator. But suppose the angles are large and we want to consider what is the effect of those large angles, that is small angle approximation is not valid. So we would like to include one more term in the small angle expansion, and that term will become theta cube by 6. Now we see that this is not an equation of a simple harmonic oscillator anymore, and the first correction that we see over here, this is the first enharmonic correction. This equation is an equation of an enharmonic oscillator. The enharmonicity is given by theta cube term over here, and the two particular features that are notable in this equation, one is that the dominant term is the linear restoring force, that is the first term in the force is proportional to the linear term theta with a negative sign. So it's a linear restoring force as a first approximation, and the correction is given by theta cube by 6, which is not a linear term, therefore this is enharmonic. So we expect an oscillation to go back and forth, but not like a sinusoidal oscillation, but something more general in nature. Such an equation we may not be able to solve analytically. Very few enharmonic oscillators we can solve analytically, very few solutions we know analytically. So in this particular case, we may have to resort to numerical techniques, for which you should wait for a little while, and as we progress the course, we'll catch up on to solving these equations by numerical techniques. Let's also go ahead and analyze this particular enharmonic oscillator from a point of view of a potential. As I said before, analyzing things from the potential can be a lot easier than thinking in terms of force. So in this case, we'll also analyze from the point of view of potential. The potential, of course, is mgl 1 minus cosine theta, as we have talked about it before. Let's expand cosine theta as a small angle approximation. The first term is 1, the first term is 1, second is minus theta squared by 2, and the third is plus theta power 4 by 24. So when I substitute that, this is what I get for the potential. Mgl theta squared by 2 minus theta to the power 4 by 24. Now that potential is an enharmonic potential because it's not quadratic anymore. This is theta to the power 4 by 24 correction, and therefore this is enharmonic. Now why did we not include the other terms over here or other terms in this particular case? That will depend on at what accuracy you want to calculate. Suppose you want to calculate perturbatively, then and really your angles are, you know, reasonably small but not small enough to consider them as harmonic oscillators, then you can truncate this expansion up to this term or over theta power 24 in the potential. So that truncation will be good truncation when the angles are small but not small enough to be considered as simple harmonic oscillator. But really depends on your accuracy of an experiment that you are doing or accuracy of a calculation that you are doing. You can decide where do you want to truncate. If you are numerically solving, it might be just good enough to take the entire this entire potential or this entire force minus g by L sine theta into consideration for solving. So really the approximation where you should truncate the series in theta depends on what is the accuracy of your calculation. So this was an example of an enharmonic oscillator, and we will continue next time with more examples.